We can all do our part to make where we live a better place. And here at Fox 8, we take that responsibility to heart. This year marks the 27th anniversary of the founding of our parent company, Nexstar. And we are all celebrating with a day of caring. This year, we'll lend a hand to BackPack Beginnings. Parker White started the nonprofit nearly 14 years ago. She had the simple goal of feeding children. And as you're about to hear, that original vision has grown to not only provide food to thousands of children, but to serve them and their families in many other ways. Fox 8's Neil McNeil has the story.
We have
Parker White grew up in Greensboro. But it was while she was living in our nation's capital that she got the idea for BackPack Beginnings.
I was living in Washington, D.C. when I was pregnant with my first child and saw a news program highlighting a teacher in Texas that was sneaking food into her students' backpacks because they were hungry when they came back to school on Mondays. And for some reason, that news program just stuck with me.
When her husband's career brought her young family back home, she decided it was the right time to start making an impact.
I called the Gilbert County School Nutrition Office, and they said there was a huge food insecurity need in this area. And honestly, I was surprised because I did grow up here in Greensboro, and I went to public schools my entire school career, and I did not know about that need.
Parker started asking friends and family for money and food donations. At her dining room table, she assembled bags for children at Wiley Elementary School. It was a way to provide necessities while easing the burden on teachers, and Parker was good at it.
I raised more money than I needed for one school. So one school led to two, and two led to three. And I continued to ask the social workers, if these families and children are struggling for food, what other items are they struggling for? And I would hear about clothing or school supplies or hygiene products. And continue to think, we can do that. We can take that on. We can add this.
With BackPack Beginnings outgrowing Parker's dining room, Guilford Child Development stepped in. The nonprofit operated out of the organization's basement. When that wasn't enough space, BackPack Beginnings moved to Alliance Drive. 3,000 square feet, then 9,000, allowed Parker's vision to expand too.
And over that time, we grew the number of schools we served, we grew the number of items we distributed, and then we started bringing in non-school partners like healthcare settings and the Greensboro Housing Authority.
Parker's own children were also growing. Her son and daughter, along with her faith, served as constant inspiration to keep going.
That I am a mom, and I can't imagine my children wanting for those basic needs. I can't imagine loving a child as much as these other moms do, but not having the resources to provide for them, be it food or clothing or hygiene products or comfort items.
Providing those other items required yet another move to BackPack Beginnings' current warehouse, also on Alliance Drive. It provides 29,000 square feet for volunteers to deliver, sort, and shelve items for families. A family market opened in 2022 that allows guests to shop for what they need.
We're trying to build this culture here where everyone is welcome, from the volunteers to the family. It really needs to be about the people.
The people are what Parker says still drives her nearly 14 years later. As she looks ahead to what's next for BackPack Beginnings, she's committed to keeping children at the center of it all.
Children are so innocent, and they didn't choose what situation they were born into, and we don't want them to grow up in a life of hunger or clothing that doesn't fit or being made fun of because they don't have hygiene products. We want them to thrive and enjoy their childhood, and we can do that.
We hope you'll tune in to see us get involved to serve children in Guilford County. We'll be sharing ways that you can get involved throughout the day, too. Join us for Fox 8's Founders Day of Caring, starting at 8 a.m. on Friday.